Hello, boys and girls, and welcome back to the exciting world of food transportation. We are seeing our train from Pueblo to Salt Lake City, picking up food, transporting it back to Pueblo, and give food to the people. And in this episode, the first thing I want to work on is to get another food transportation or another food train or raw material train, how we call this, grain and livestock transport on the rails, because our train station here is about to overflow. We have 140 items waiting. The Yonkers farm is producing like hell and has an upgrade scheduled, so it gets really time to get another train on the tracks. And we should do that as quick as possible before our food production plummets to a halt. We don't want that to happen. As we can see, the production here is quite a bit slow to support Salt Lake City and Pueblo. So the upgrade of the farm is actually a good thing. We just need to take care that we can get all the goods from the farm over here to the food processing facility, or food processing plant, that's the word. After we have done this, I most likely will extend the food delivery over here to Naperville. That seems like a good plan to me. And I think I can use the train who also delivers to Pueblo. Then he doesn't stand around, or it doesn't stand around and wait to be filled. And it can deliver to the other town, deliver to the other town each turn. In order to buy another train, we need to have, that's another thing. I included our logo in the game now. You can see, when you take a close look on the train engine, let's go a little bit back. Where does it stop? There does it stop. On the train engine, we have our logo now. Also here. I still have to put a text on it. I'm not quite sure about the style. That will happen in one of the next episodes. And maybe I can change the logo a bit to fit better into the time. But where I was going to was the second train. And in order to buy the second train, we need to have roughly 1 more million. And as soon as the delivery here arrives on the food processing plant, we should have enough in our pocket to be able to buy the second train. Let me just check this for a second. What do I have on this track? The Mogul or the Baldwin? Let me check this out. That is a Mogul. most likely a mogul. So we need a mogul for roughly 1 million. Then we need livestock cars and grain cars. They cost the same, so that's not an issue. And I want to basically duplicate this train. So let's just count quickly. We have 4 carts for livestock and 10 carts for grain. Yeah, that looks fine. And of course our food production goes down because we don't have raw materials. That's the main reason why we need a second train. We will get there in a second. Almost there. Come on, you can do it. Hop, hop. You are driving 75 kilometers an hour. Let me feel that. There we go. Almost there. 1 more meter. Give me a big payday. Wonderful, 1.1 million. That should be enough to actually buy the train. So we need 1 mogul. And I need to borrow more money. Wait a second. So 1 mogul, 4 carts for the livestock and 10 for grain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. And you go on to Yonkers Salt Lake City raw food. Beautiful. There he comes, our shiny new livestock transport and grain transport. And what's the overall title for this, word for this? I don't know. But it's shiny and new, and shiny and new is always good. So hopefully... Oh, why you don't slow down production? That is not nice. Probably because there's too much waiting here. Could you speed up? Thank you. Yeah, now we get speed in production here again. The food processing plant is also speeding up. And hopefully we will have enough raw materials soon to have a continuous production. Let me just check out raw food, fully load any, this is fine. Okay. Let's observe that for a minute. Now let's go with the, no, the new train has to wait too long. Go with the old train. Old train is maybe the wrong word. It's still nice and shiny also. I don't know, how old is it now? It is, oh, 23 years already. For that, it still looks surprisingly good. We have a little bit of corrosion there, but overall, you are 23 years old already. Time flies. Time really flies. And that means we also have to replace this train soon. Something I don't really like. But I think it's not the engine what is so old, it's the carbs. Of course the engine still looks quite new. I don't know. We might need to check this out later. I think I bought the train right here when the running cost started to spike. So maybe it's 10 years old. But who knows? So what do we have waiting? That is still almost a full train there. It actually is a full train because the livestock is 62. That is more than our train can take. So he will drive this route. With not much grain, but this is fine. Totally fine. What are you producing? Your production goes down again. Why this? Why is the potential zero? What is happening? You are producing like hell. Why does your production slow down? Too much livestock waiting? Interesting. Let's see what happens when the second train arrives here. When this second train killed our production chain, I get really pissed. Oh no, now we speed up the production again. Okay, there we go. Just a minor hiccup. Yeah. Try to ship more grain. I ship grain without end. So let's see, we don't have much grain on this trip. I really don't like this. But hey, our livestock needs to be transported too, so it's fine for now. Just wait here for a second. I just want to give it a little bit more of grain. There we go. Now you can load. Load. No path. Why is there no path? You are in the train station. What are you talking about? Yeah, never touch this here. When the route is working, don't touch it. Why is there no path? You're basically sitting on it. That was a mess. Okay, now you are outside the station, turn around and go back and get your load. Wonderful. Don't slow down, I transported already. This AI is really, really nervous. Yeah. Basically no grain, and there's still a lot of livestock left. Hopefully we can, I don't want to close this. Hopefully we can transport that away in the near future. Should I put a third train on this? Only for livestock? I don't know. It's fine for now. We have other things to do too. Production here is... You are out of... How the hell are you doing this? I think our trucks here might be a problem. Maybe I should put this train station up here, cut out the middlemen, and let those trains transport all the stuff directly. Let me just check the height difference. When we go directly up here. Oh no, there's the fields. That's not good. I don't want to take away the fields because that will be freaking expensive. But we might wait. We might get away with it when we just cut out one field and go through here. How much would that cost? Can I? Wait. 200,000. One field costs 200,000. What do you think? Should I do it? What's this train doing? What's the farm doing? Farm raises production, but we have a bottleneck here. I think it's a bottleneck. Yeah, I think before I expand the food delivery to any other town, I really need to optimize the workflow here. So we might not have much of a choice than to put the train station here and go the direct route. That also might save us a good chunk of time. Yeah, let's do that. The question now is, can I put a road, a small road, around here without cutting the field away? Is it possible? One field will be removed. That's not nice. $55,000 for a small road. Are you crazy? No, definitely not. Okay, where do we put this? Okay. Wait, we have our trains sitting right here. So I basically want to build the train station here, where the truck stop is right now. I think that makes the most sense, but is most likely also the most expensive. But it's fine, this route will bring the money back. Now what I worry about is, when I take away this truck route now, then production here will slow down. If production here slows down, production there will slow down. And that's something I like to avoid. But I think I might not really have a chance to do it any differently. Yeah. Okay, let's... What is this here? Upgrade. What is this? Street modification. Okay. This is Yonkers Food Exchange, and we basically want to sell the whole line. And also delete the whole line. Okay, so now we take this depot and this depot away. The train can still transport this all the way. This is fine. Come on, guys, faster. Time is of the essence. I hope I can get it built before production here slows down. Maybe not. But that's the sacrifice we have to make. So now I can take this road away and this depot. And we build a freight station. The question is, do I build it like this? What is very, very expensive? Or do I build it as a terminal? What is much cheaper? Okay, the question basically answered itself. We go with a terminal. $123. That looks fine. Give it a little. Wait, can we lay two tracks? Two tracks. Just to make it sure it fits. So 164. Yeah, that's the cheapest. There we go. And now let's hope. Now let's hope that the street connection, or that the farm is still in the catchment area. Yeah, perfect. Perfect, that is what I wanted to see. And now let's build the tracks, which will be a very expensive fun too, but we have to do it. It's not much of a choice we have. Let's go right there. It looks fine. And go down here. No. Go down here. Fine. And go over. What are you doing? How is the slope here? It comes down. This is fine. Okay. Now make it straight. You don't need to go up. Just make it kind of straight. Why the hell would you want to go up? Is there a freaking hill? Really? There is a hill. Oh, come on. Okay, that will be an expensive hobby. Do we still go in the right direction? I could build a tunnel. That theoretically looks like a good idea. I want to connect it to here. And that costs 600,000. But for Christ's sake, I could have put a tunnel earlier and avoid the field. Yeah, it's okay. We take it. We take it. And the second track. Yeah, relax, relax. The second track goes right there. Now we just need to connect this. Wait. Come on, don't be like this. We connect the second track right here. Cut, boom. And Now we just need to change our route. Lose a bit of livestock, but that's okay. So this is Yonkers raw food. And we go instead of Yonkers West, we go to Yonkers Exchange. We remove Yonkers West. And there we go. Now we just need to put in some extra tracks here. What the hell are you doing? There we go. Yeah, 50 kilometers an hour is fine. And we also want to go in the other direction. Can we do this? We totally can do this. Wonderful. Now we just need a signal here. And we are golden. The second train already takes the right direction. Where are we? There. And now let's see. Production slowed down considerably. But let's see, as soon as the train is here, hopefully the farm will pick up with production again. It is covered, so that should be fine. A train is coming, and the speed is okay. For the kind of slope it has to take, the speed is really okay. Nothing to worry. Yeah. Our farm figured out that the new material delivery is existing and production goes up again. Wonderful. That's all we wanted. Now we have an optimized route and we can basically take the old train station and the old tracks away because they just cost maintenance. And at the moment we just need to save as much money as possible. Almost there, kids, almost there. Now let's see. Construction not possible. Why is construction not possible? Okay, let's pause here for a short second. Let's take this away. Why can I not take this away? Hello? I cannot remove a track? Okay, there we go. All is fine. No panic. Now we just reconnect this right here. Come on, reconnect. Beautiful. Reconnect. There we go. Looks smooth. All is fine. So now hopefully the farm production speeds up rather quickly because We have people to feed. How do it look? Does it look? 5 livestock. Farm, what are you doing? Come on. Come on, you can do it. There's a second train coming. Speed it up. I wish I could, before I change line, go to the owner of the farm and say, don't worry, just produce it. We just moved the train station. We come afterwards directly and pick up your goods. Make your storage full, everything will be fine. But no, of course that's not possible. So we have to deal with the side effects, which costs us a good deal of money, but I think that is part of the fun of the game. Come on now. Production is 40. Come, you can do it. Speed it up. Why do I hear planes in 1892? That's a bit weird. Come on, you can do it. What do we get? A trolley. I don't need a trolley. What's a trolley? Is this a tram or is this something extra? I think it's a tram. So now we have two of our trains waiting here to get filled, really? Please don't tell me you fill them all at the same time. You don't. Okay, that's at least something. But that is actually something I quite like. So when you have space in a train station and one of your lanes is busy, the train automatically drives to the other free lane. That is actually really nice. I didn't know you can do that. I think that's also a new thing to Transport Fever. I know in Train Fever it was not possible. I really like this feature. I'm glad they put it in. So now let's see. We have 19 livestock, 15 grain. Production slowly comes up. Come on, fill at least the livestock. 82 production. Of course, production down here crumbles to a halt. Yeah. This is not good. Please don't downgrade. How is our passenger service doing? 99 people waiting. Okay. Passenger trains come in. How much do you make? 250,000, that's fine. And look, they have our logo on the side. It doesn't really fit into the time. The style is a bit too modern. I really will try to make something more appropriate for our transportation company, but it's nice that we can put it in there. Okay, our first food transport on the new line is on its way. It's basically half empty, but we will not complain. And now production here picks up. This is good. Yeah. We will be back on track in no time. And we better will be, because we have hungry people waiting for their breakfast cereals, and we also still want to expand the food delivery line. You are going downhill and still have problems to speed up. Okay. Interesting. But the track is a lot shorter now, so we should get a bit more profit out of this line. And I wonder if I should change the layout of the trains a little bit to put the same amount of livestock and grain carts on it, because it quite seems like the farm is producing the same amount of each now. And with the train station directly connected to it, it might be that that is a thing. Let's just do it. We need to maximize our profit, and that's the way to go, I think. Don't downgrade, don't even think about downgrading. There we go, production is speeding up again. Not much, I think, but it will give us something. So now we need to change our layout here a little bit. We have more than enough grain cars. So wait, how long is this train? 6 Okay. Sell this, sell this. Buy this. Buy this. Buy. Borrow this. Buy this. Buy this, and then let's quickly change this. This is 8 of those and 8 of those. Perfect. Is it too long? Okay, let's take one away from each, so 7 and 7. All is fine. Yonkers raw food, you are on the way. Are you still downgrading? No. Wonderful. Your production is still rising. Let me just have an overview here. I'm sorry that it's a little bit cluttered on the screen right now, but I need to make sure that everything is in sync. Okay, the train definitely fits in the station. Production here is going up. The next delivery is on its way. Let's put this over here. And let's put them a little bit out of the way. There we go. Wonderful. And into the depot with you. And we had 7 of each car on the other train. So let's go for this on this train too. So 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. We need 3 more box cards. 1, 2, 3. You go up, and then you all go up. What do we have? Steam lorry. That might be something to update our transport line. But we don't have much transportation by truck right now. Okay, set line, Yonkers raw food. You are on your way. Yonkers Farm is producing 180 Salt Lake City food production. Now they seem to be in sync. The first train is almost there. What do we have waiting here? Oh yeah, that looks good. That looks wonderful. Of course, now it produces more grain than livestock again. But it's fine, the utilization is a good bit better, I think. Almost a full train. Perfect. So you hopefully will upgrade very soon. This is train number one. Where's train number two and why is it crawling? You are empty. For Christ's sake, speed up a bit. I know you drive uphill, but come on. So how's it looking here? We are out of raw materials again, and this train didn't even move in the last year. Right? In the last 2 years it didn't move. Yeah, that has to change rather quickly. So let's take a look at our lines. The only route where we have trucks on is Salt Lake City food delivery. And actually, we can put a good chunk of those away, I think. They are just coasting money. But there you are. Okay. And now we want to replace them with our steam lorry. Wait, let's check this. Yep, that makes sense. Okay, please replace as fast as possible. Wait, how expensive is it? 31,000. That's fine. Replace away. There comes our next delivery. And please let it be a big chunk. And our farm is about to get upgraded. Wonderful. Payday, ladies and gentlemen. $1 million. 1.1. Nothing to complain. There comes the second train. and we are getting the goods faster away than the farm produces it. That is a very good thing. That is what should happen. No, don't slow down. Keep it up. Nice. And a almost full train is on its way again. That's what I like to see. We still have enough raw materials, so maybe the train can deliver raw materials before our processing plant is running out of it. And our food delivery to Pueblo is finally full. It is a beautiful day, ladies and gentlemen. All our plans work out finally. And our farm just got upgraded. Wonderful. Wonderful. Hopefully we will get faster trains very soon to keep the farm and the production plant in sync. Otherwise, I might have to add a third train onto it, but we will see what time tells us. $1 million right there, and the storage of the food processing plant is filled again. The second train is almost on its way. There it goes, and look at the farm. Look at it going. 284. This thing is exploding. The same with the food production or the food processing plant. 268. Now our production is going somewhere. Wonderful. All our trucks are on their way. No long lines anymore. That is just perfect. And we are making money. Look at this. 2.3 million. I can repay quite some loan here. What we have waiting here? 30. So the whole delivery for the strain is almost, only the half of this is almost done, but by the time the strain arrives here, he will be almost full. What do we get? A steak car. What is a steak car? What can we transport with it? Log, steel, blanks, construction. No, that is not really interesting. Not right now. Where are our raw materials? On their way. Wonderful. What do we have waiting here? 350. So our farm is about to upgrade again. And we don't have enough trains. It really seems I need to put a third train on this track. That is just crazy. Just look at this. This train arrives and already have a full load here. If that doesn't call for a third train, then I don't know what does. And I think I will just put some signals here and here so we have enough space that trains can be in the same direction. And we just go with it and put another train on it. I mean, look at this. The farm. I don't know if she can upgrade. That's the question. Let's wait here for a second. Can the farm upgrade another time to 800 or something? No upgrade or downgrade scheduled. Would another train be waste? Or not? Okay, you know what? Let's repay this loan. And I think this question we will answer in the next episode. We went on quite a while on today. We didn't get much done, but I think the improvement we made is clearly visible. Yeah, this train is halfway back and there's a full load already available. Very clearly visible that there is an improvement. So we will see if the farm can upgrade another level. And if so, we will put a third train on this track. And what we also will do in the next episode is finally extend our food delivery over here to Naperville and maybe to Riverside. If we do this, then we also have to extend our passenger service over to Riverside. Exciting times are coming. We are almost in the 1900s. So it will be a lot of action in the next episodes. But for now, give this video a like if you like it. If you don't like the video and you like me, then also give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It helps me really out and you don't miss any new episodes coming out. Yeah, share the video around and most importantly, tell me in the comments, what should I do? Should I extend our production line? Should I extend our passenger line? Should I go with something completely different? And please don't ask for an airport, not yet. It will come later on, but at the moment we don't really have any routes what could be improved by an airport. Yeah, let me know what you think. I hope I see you all in the next video. Until then, have a good one.